Alright, hey guys, it's Pee-wee here, and I have another replay analysis video that I will be doing for you guys. And I just accidentally paused it. Oops. Okay, we have a PvZ here on the Cloud Kingdom, and of course I'm watching the Protoss, because I'm a Protoss. And this is a Platinum League game, and I have watched it before. But the recording wasn't so good, so I'm pretty much redoing it. Alright, so immediately we see a in-base expand. Normally on this map, like, the guy was a Platinum, and I read it, he said, like, you know, this is his opening. On a map like this, you can really get away with a fast expansion, you know, with a Forge fast expand. So try putting that into some consideration. Alright, okay, you delay the expansion, that's good. That's very good, that's what you want to be doing. You can leave it there, that's your call, it's up to you. To this. Now, this is actually, when you look at the game so far, this is actually quite beneficial for you in a sense. Because, so you know you just one based over here, right? He's not, he can take a third, but if he does, he's just going to have less units when you attack. And if he doesn't take that base, then these two are very far apart, and that one is very easy to snipe. But it seems you went for, since you went for, you know, expansions and stuff, that's fine. So, also, I noticed this as well, like, you put all your buildings in visible. You know, he can see them pretty much, apart from your robo. But if he went the furthest he could probably see that robo. And obviously, you're pretty much giving him the scouting information he wanted. So I would recommend putting your buildings pretty much not at your ramp. pretty much, yeah. Now, in the email the dude sent me with the replay, and, you know, it's nice to give a description, because then I can see what you're aiming for, I can see it, like, I can give you better advice based upon what you're aiming for and stuff like that. And he pretty much says he has a problem with PvZ, right? He hates PvZ and how, you know, it's such a macro intensive against them and stuff like that. It's very hard to defeat them once they get the ball rolling. And that's pretty true, actually. It's very hard. And because of that, he said he tried a bunch of different builds, and as we can see here, we got a 3-gate robo, which isn't really the build of choice against a Zerg. It's really not. it can do okay. It's at one base, obviously, so you kind of have to attack them. Whereas you go for your expansion way too late, which is like 8 minutes into the game, which is probably very, very late. You just, like, you build your units, you don't really do much, you chill, you don't expand for so long. It's sort of like your income, like, you're 25 harvesters. So right now, like, you know, you should have a couple more, you should have your expansion on the way. Like, you could have it on the way already. Alright, so we're doing a drop with the War Prism, which is cool. We have the expansion now, which is good. The pylon, as soon as the pylon finishes, you want a forge. Always have a forge and a cannon, mate. Always. And I seen this drop, and this, I think this game, you were just very lucky. Well, actually, maybe not so much. You were lucky because your opponent played quite bad this game. Like, he didn't react very fast to this. He's very slow. So you had, done a lot of economic damage here, actually. Like, the queen just doesn't react. The queen comes and fights, and then this one does, and this one does, and you fight them, and you build more zealots, which is awesome. Like, really cost efficient, you're killing drones. I don't know why you warped in a stalker, that was stupid. Like, if you're gonna warp in a stalker, save the stalker. Because, you know, they're expensive, man. You can't just let them die. In the meantime, like, your opponent is terrible macro. And here's next to this, look at the units. Okay, he has 11 lava, so he's hitting bad drone timings, his inject timings rather. He only just finished speed and all that. And then you come in, like, you do get good force fields. Let's see. So this looks like engagement. You could have definitely had a better engagement. You have some nice force fields. Like, in the meantime though, like, while this is doing damage, you're certainly doing damage. Like, it's Immortals v Roaches, so Immortals come out ahead there. You gotta make sure you don't lose the sentries because they're so gas intensive. You know, you want better control and stuff like that. Like, it would have been better to go for this expansion first and stuff like that. Back at home, you're not doing anything. Actually, you're just absolutely not doing anything in any regard. You're not mining from your base. You have no forge. Like, you have absolutely no forge. How can you, like, you've had your expansion like 2 minutes now, or a minute at least, and there's not a probe. It's not even hotkeyed. Your gateway's not even hotkeyed. Your cybernet, your robo's not even hotkeyed. Nothing's hotkeyed. Your army's not even hotkeyed. Only the war prism. Use your hotkeys. Yeah, build a forge, build probes, rally them. It's so stupid. What's the point of expanding if you're not going to mine from it? Seriously. So that's something you need to work on. Hey, if you're going to attack, at least, you know, macro behind it. Like, yeah, you know, I like the way you walk the force, the ramp to lower the surface area. You missed that force field, so you get surrounded. You're not really building units. You haven't built anything for a while, I don't think. Okay, there we are. Like, you're doing a lot of damage, just mainly because your opponent has no lava and he can't build roaches. He's not even injecting. He's not injecting that one. He's injecting that one. That's dead, so. You know, it's just very poor macro by your opponent. Look at his money. Look how many roaches he's producing. So I believe the reinforcements will clean up here, is it? No? Okay, get into the main. Oh my god. I can't believe this is doing so much damage. He doesn't fight with drones, he doesn't save his drones. Okay, now you're building stuff at home. Finally, you still have no forge. At least you're mining. That's an improvement. But, come on, you want the forge down ASAP. Look how much money you have and how much gas you have. That's not useful to you. Why no sentries? Why no sentries by here just to stop a counterattack? Like, sentries use mana, so you want to warp them in faster so you get more energy. Your opponent attacks in groups of units, so you do a lot more damage. If you attack in like groups of five, you're gonna stomp it easier. You know, if you have six groups of five units that swarm you, like, you know, you kill five, then five more come, and then you kill them, five more come. You're gonna be obviously a lot more better at killing them. If instead like 30 come at you, you're fucked. So it's definitely his fault for bad reinforcements, bad control, bad injects, bad awareness, and just terrible response. Your opponent was playing awful, like, really bad. You're definitely playing better than him, but at the same time you're playing, you know, your economy is awful. Absolutely awful. Terrible. Like, you build cannons in front. What the hell? Like, you're meant to build them behind so they don't die straight away. Like, if anything comes up here, they're the first things I get shot at. Like, what's the point? Just wasting money. You're building a car, you know, probes now, you're getting plus one, that's good, you're using your forge. The strategy, personally, I don't know, isn't really that beneficial to you. Fair enough, the war prism is, but if you go for blind immortals, you're hoping on a lot of stuff. You're hoping pretty much your opponent goes roaches. If he doesn't go roaches, you're dead. If he goes pure zerglings, you're dead. If he goes hydras, you're dead. Or near enough. If he goes linen faster, you're dead. If he goes muters, you're dead. So, like you just got lucky with that, the build order win to an extent. You know, that he went for roaches, that you forced him to build roaches, and then he didn't attack you in a good fashion, made him lose. I believe, like, your opponent was ahead until pretty much you attacked, and then he just fell apart and lost it. Like, he was ahead, it was his game to lose, and he bloody well did. We got another robo. That's a bit questionable, seems... Okay, let's see what you build first. It's like quite late. It's pretty late into the game, so... Like... It's a bit pointless having just double robo. If you double robo Colossus, then that's a big difference. Double Immortals... This late into the game is very risky. So back here he's mining. So you haven't really done much. Like, you've done that nice attack, and fair enough, you stayed there and killed a lot of stuff, but seriously, like, your opponent didn't react at all or well. Not even a little bit well. That was just really bad on his part. So double Immortals, is it, yeah? Double Immortals, you know, works, but it's normally what you want earlier. That's pretty good. I like the efficiency. That's not the efficiency. The idea you have, you know, you stop the War Prism, you realize, hey, I can warp in units here, I need them. And you do that, that's great. And then you carry on with it. I don't think you do that, I think you just let units chill here. And you warp in here as well? No, all the cannons and the Immortal. And then there's an Immortal by here, yeah. So that, like, the only reason you dealt well for that counterattack is because you're just bad macro. There's no rally point on the robo. That's literally, if that hadn't have thinned, you probably would have lost a couple of probes. So back to here, you've got a nice army, you're certainly ahead. Like, now the economies are even, but if you look at it, like, you've killed 55 workers. That's awful. You 9,000 minerals killed. Your opponent just played bad, man. I would much throw this in your opponent's favor for him losing it than you winning it. Like, I would say he lost it more than you won it. Absolutely, yeah, definitely. Because, you know, if he had any type of well, I know last night, because I watched the replay, that he didn't have any units until you attacked with the War Prism, which is just fucking stupid on his part. Absolutely retarded. Like, I can't put into words how stupid it is on his part just to have 2 Zerglings and 55 drones. Like, he deserved to lose, because he was playing too greedy or whatever, or he was unaware or something, and he deserved it. You know, that doesn't mean necessarily take everything away, you just weren't magically given the win. Like, it was a bit of luck with the build. The build, I wouldn't say, was very good. Your expansion wasn't the best. You were certainly, when you've done the push, I would say you were certainly aware of what to do, like the force fields, what to attack. The only problem is you weren't macro and behind it, even kind of. Like, how you didn't have a probe at this base for like 4 minutes is absurd. Absolutely bloody absurd. So you've definitely made a crap ton of mistakes. Your strategy, if you want to expand, your strategy either is a forge fast expand or a 3-gate expand, or something like a 2-gate stargate, something like that. Those are your pretty much your only variations. The 3-gate robo is kind of all in PvZ, especially if you go for Immortals, because if he goes for Zerglings, like I just said, you kind of die. So it's a bit of a silly call. Like, I would recommend going for Void Rays. Imagine you had Void Rays. Like, at your level, like, people are bad. Like, if you kill the queens, say, with the Void Ray push, like, if you push with Void Rays and some other units, and you kill the queens, you're so far ahead. You could do so much damage, because people around this level just don't know how to react accordingly. React efficiently without losing many units, what to build, and that is a very easy way to win, I must say. Someone tell me. So back into this. This is completely straightforward. You have absolutely way more forces than him, and you stomp him. I can't say anything else. Like you have bad awareness here. You're not really doing anything. You didn't use your sentries. Well, you know, you turned into a warp prism, warp mode, and warped in some units. That's pretty good. Definitely. But then, of course, you just have to have good control when you walk in by here. If you select all the stalkers and, like, click to by here, the ones on the high ground are going to come down and they're going to get attacked and whatever. So you have to have good control when you walk in the high ground. You walked it. Why would you warp in sentries into the guy's base? Actually, let's look at that again, just so I can insult you some more. Because that was awful. Why would you... Sentries are expensive, mate. Expensive units. You don't want to give sentry units just die. You don't want to warp them in and just let them die. It's stupid. You have to love your sentries. Sentries are so important. Just warp them in. You have no thought about what you build. You just warp them in. You're just like, yeah, why not? I have warp-ins. Let me build stuff. You have to put logic to it. You can't just build sentries in a base when you've been attacked by roaches, because they're not good units against roaches. That was stupid. That was really absurdly stupid. Like, I'm not impressed by that. I have all that. You need to learn what goes where. Like, you warp the range units on the ground, yeah? Like, I wish I could have something physical to slap, because that's actually aggravated me quite a lot, because that was just stupid. That was unexplainably stupidity. Yeah, like, you should have had the warp prisms below, right? So that way you can warp on the high ground and the low ground. Or the low ground, which is that, and the high ground here. Alright, so you warp in zealots here. And guess what? Sentries and stalkers down here. Why? Because they're ranged units. If you have a unit below, right? See, now he has a roach right below. If you warp in a stalker below, all that you're letting happen is it can die faster. That's all that's happening. If you put it below, guess what? It can still attack the same roach. Yeah, you just letting him have units to kill them. Stupid. Awful, 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 awful. And I can't be polite about that. That's inexcusable in my eyes. Like, sentries are just absurdly expensive. You have to learn to love your sentries, not just let them sacrifice like that. Like, you honestly didn't have any care in the world. You just literally just warped them in. Let's go back to that again, so I can insult you some more. I'm like offended that you've done that. Because sentries are just so important. You just warp them in. You have no care at all. So yeah, learn to love your units and realize, you know, where is the correct position to put units. Like, zealots in the high ground, ranged units on the low ground. Like, oh my god. I want to cry watching this. It's terrible. Let me just fight sentries with roaches, yes. You know, because that's always an efficient fight, isn't it? You didn't even use your force fields. Like, if you force fielded the ramp, then it's okay. Then it's excusable, I guess. If you have a point for that force field. Like, you can sacrifice a zealot and a sentry if it does its job. But you just sacrifice it. You don't give a crap about what its job is. You just sacrifice it. It's terrible. Absolutely terrible. So let's look at things like economy. Not so bad. 51 is okay for your level for a platinum. This is bad. You just have your probes just chilling. Not how long are these not mining for? Okay, quite not a while, because there's patches here, but it's just like you got two patches and you got seven. No. It's 21 probes, just on two batches, so you've got an inefficiency of about 17 there, so that's bad. Like, that does happen, you're, you know, you're micro-ing down here and stuff, but obviously the emblem of idle workers comes there, so you should be a bit more aware, like mid. So yeah, I would say you the only reason you really won this is your opponent played terrible, even worse than you. This, you know, there are some certain good things that you've done. I'm not going to absolutely criticize you into hell and stop you pretty much playing this game. You know, you were very aware to know when you were ahead, so you pushed again. That's actually one of the harder things people don't do, to know when they're ahead and to know when they can win the game. And you've done that, you've stomped them, as you've seen, like, you were way, 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 way ahead at this point. It didn't matter that you lost the sentries, I'm just saying, like, that needs to be, like, a reflex. It's not something, like, you should be doing. It's, like, it's so bad that you have to learn to automatically not do it. It's just one of those things. Just, you shouldn't let that happen. You should be disgusted with yourself. You should, if you can, if you're watching this, slap yourself right now. So yeah, that is definitely, I would say, covers that replay. I do apologize for being quite harsh. I don't exactly have the, you know, I'm quite a patient person and all that, but like, when people send me replays, they're like, oh yeah, commentate this, tell me how good I done, and then they do, like, the most stupidest things, like warping sentries up there, like, that's just unforgivable. Like, you, and like, look at these both sentries, the one's got 200, one's got 138. Guess what, I haven't seen force fields in quite a while. Did you see any? No, you didn't, because you didn't use any, that's why, yes. So, yeah, just disappointing play, I would say. You still won, but I would say your opponent cocked it up. I'm trying to find some other things that you would have done. You know, you took a third. That's so late, but that's fine. You took a third, you had the right idea. You didn't get your upgrades continued. You didn't continue producing from you. You didn't have these hotkeyed. You had nothing hotkeyed apart from your two Nexus and your War Prism. You didn't even have your army hotkeyed. That is pretty unforgivable as well, actually. You have no further tech going on. You have no care about tech. You have no Robo, no Twilight, no extra upgrades, no Stargate. No cadets here. You didn't have your forge straight away. You didn't. Your expansion was ridiculously late. As a platinum, how you were doing this build as a platinum, I would really question your skill level, because if you're a platinum, you shouldn't be doing this. And you should know you shouldn't be doing this. I know platinums who fast forward. You know, I know platinums who would laugh their asses off at this themselves, a platinum. Like, and you're at the same level as them. And I honestly know people who would laugh at this, who are platinums. So, terrible build. Like I said, the only builds you really want to be doing, if you're on one base, this is an all-in. You don't expand off this. If you turn that into a Stargate, then that's doable, but you would chop off one gateway. Because this is, you can't afford to produce off these gateways and this. If you actually produce off all these three and that, you do not have enough money to build an expansion. So, just do some, just forge fast, expand. I don't even think the forge is touching the wall, so Zerglings could just run through there. Like, how can you be platinum and not know how to wall in? Like, seriously, like, learn building placements, what the hell? Like, there is actually a gap there, that Zerglings could run by there. Zerglings can run by there. That is an awful wall. There's nothing to stop Zerglings just, you know, apart from the cannons, but, like, the cannons are at the front. Great. Like, that's just silly play. What else have we got going on? So, yeah, I would say I hit a lot of your criticisms there. I would definitely say you just, I would say I covered everything there. Alright, this is actually probably fairly long, even though I said like a 20-minute game, it's still going to be like a 20-minute, 25-minute VOD. So hopefully you're learning these things I would say your major problem is your build is terrible, and two, you don't, even if you do like the certain build, you're not even doing it correct. Like you're not walling in. Like if you forge fast expand and this is how you forge, your forge goes, that's awful. That's terrible. That is inexcusable in every single way, and you deserve to lose every game you play where you do that. Because that's just bad. Absolutely terrible. So yeah, you know, the forge goes by there, you build a pylon there, you have another gateway by there, next to the forge. So, let's say that again, forge, gateway, pylon, and then you have one gap, right? And you put a zealot on hold. That's how you forge fast expand. The pylon, that pylon, fine. But the forge is terrible. And the cannons. The cannons go behind the wall. Behind the forge, rather. So yeah, okay, that is the end of that replay analysis. So, like I said, I do apologise for being quite harsh, because I was, but warping in sentries really annoyed me. That is inexcusable. So, I've definitely given you some criticism, and I've definitely given you some things that I was a fan of, like the force fields. You know, you had the right initiative to realize when you were far enough ahead that you could go kill him, and that is something that's actually very good. So keep working on that, just work on your opening and your macro, right? Like, you didn't have probes, so opening and macro. Right? Opening and macro. Just remember that. That is your problem, and that is what needs to be solved. Alright, mate? So, yeah, hope you enjoyed. Take care, guys. Please follow me on Twitter and sub to my YouTube. Yeah, there we are. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.